Quick! You are flying a long-range seaplane from Texas to California. Suddenly, you lose one of your two engines over southern Arizona. You feather the prop to the damaged engine, but there's no water anywhere around. You have no wheels, you're losing altitude, the crew is throwing everything they can out the windows. Mountains stick up to 9,000 feet, so what do? That's what pilot Scott Fitzgerald and his crew had to contend with during World War II as they were flying their Martin PBM Mariner over Arizona. I'm Chris McDaniel, and this is another edition of Warbird Show. So the crew aimed their aircraft for the Willcox Dry Lake, which also happened to be a bombing and gunnery range during World War II. But they were able to make a successful landing. Damage was minimal. The right wingtip was damaged. The right pontoon popped off. But ultimately, damage was extremely minimal. So I headed out to the dry lake bed. You can still see foundations from the old gunnery targets. You can still find a lot of old 50 caliber shells out there. And once I was able to line up the photos, well, sometimes you just have to insert yourself into the past. So carefully looking around the area, I was able to find very, very small parts of the Mariner, as well as some rivets. Because what they did during World War II, they fixed the left engine, that was the one that failed in flight. They fixed the right wing tip, and that right pontoon. They put some temporary landing gears on the aircraft and flew the aircraft off the dry lake. And as soon as the plane took off, they dropped the landing gears, so the plane was able to make a successful water landing in California. I'm Chris McDaniel, and that's another episode of Warbird Show. Until next time, keep the tails dragging, the wings bent, and keep them flying.